What is good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome into movie number 3 in the View Askewniverse. Today, I am checking out Chasing Amy from 1997 for the first time, and I am so excited to see what kind of chaotic and hilarious story they have crafted for this movie. Very excited to see what types of characters everybody is playing, with the exception of Jay and Silent Bob, because we already know who they are and what they're about. I'm very excited to see what they get up to in this movie, though. If you're new around here, hello, my name is Kale. I am making my way through this franchise for the first time. Prior to watching Clerks, I had no idea who Kevin Smith was. I had never heard of Jay and Silent Bob before. I'm very much enjoying these movies so far and cannot wait to continue. If you've missed reactions, I do have a playlist that you can save. It's my View Askewniverse playlist. And if you are interested in my reactions to the rest, make sure you're subscribed to the channel so you don't miss out. And as always, if you are someone that gets a little frustrated by these like chopped up edited versions, you can always join me and watch the full movie over on my Patreon. Just make sure you bring your own copy of it. And with that, I'm not going to waste any more time. Extra big thank you to all of you View Askewniverse fans for joining me on this journey. I love talking with you in the comments. With that, let's press play. So I did see that this movie was coded as a romance comedy. I'm down for some rom-com vibes, to be honest. Ben Affleck is back. First actor listed too, interesting. New York, New York, New York, New York. Comic-Con, yes. Amazing. Even just from seeing this, I can tell that Comic-Cons haven't really changed that much from the late 90s to now.
Could you sign it to a really big fan?
You bet. You like draw this or something?
Holden draws the pictures in pencil and then he gives it to me to go over in ink.
That's a good process.
It's not tracing, all right?
You go over what he draws with a pen, all right? That's tracing.
Not really.
He looks really good with facial hair. Just gonna throw that out there.
You want your book signed or what?
Hey, 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 hey! Just because you got a problem with your station in life.
Oh, I'm secure with what I do.
I don't want you to sign it, man. I want the guy that draws Blunt Man Chronic to sign it. You're just a tracer.
Tell him.
Little shaver. Who do I sign it to?
Neither of these guys want to be here, I feel.
Whenever an African-American character was introduced, usually by white artists and writers, they got slapped with racist names. My book, White Hatin' Coon, don't have none of that bullshit. The hero's name is Malikwa, and he's a descendant from the black tribe that established the first society on the planet while you European motherfuckers were still hiding in caves and shit. And we gonna get respect by any means necessary.
Come on, that's a bunch of horse shit. Lando Calrissian was a black guy, you know. He got to fly the Millennium Falcon. What's the matter with you?
Who said that?
Lando Calrissian is a positive role model in the realm of science.
I do love me some Lando. I named my Wi-Fi Lando, capital L-A-N, lowercase D-O.
You got cracker farm boy Luke Skywalker, Nazi poster boy, blonde hair, blue eyes. And then you got Darth Vader, the blackest brother in the galaxy, Nubian god.
What's a Nubian?
Shut the fuck up.
I love that Star Wars keeps being brought up in these movies. I feel so happy now that I like get it and I can understand and know.
Vader's beautiful black visage is sullied when he pulls off his mask to reveal a feeble, crusty old white man. They trying to tell us that deep inside, we all wants to be white.
Well, isn't that true?
Oh my God. Oh my God. She's just sitting there plugging her ears.
What's a Nubian? Bitch, you almost made me laugh.
How do you manage to get away with this all the time? I mean, shouldn't the cops be busting your head open right about now?
She full of blanks, okay.
I love him and I want him to be in this whole movie.
Black rage angle if they found out the book was written by a, you know.
Faggot?
When you say it, it sounds so sexy.
Hey, hey, hey.
Cooper, how come you sound like Minister Farrakhan when you're on stage and the King of Pop when you're not?
I wonder if she's Amy.
This pile of PMS is Alyssa Jones.
Wait, was she the one sitting at the table and plugging her ears? That looked like a completely different person.
I'm surprised we never met at any other cons before.
Yeah, we'll lose the dick or change the skin tone and we can get to know each other on panel after panel.
Wow.
I promised Alyssa I'd buy her post-rape drink. Can you stay for a round in the big, scary city?
We're gonna go.
We'll go.
Archie and the Riverdale gang were a pure and fun-loving bunch. You can't find dysfunction in those comics.
Archie was the bitch and Jughead was the butch. Be the king of Queen Archie's were.
Now I want to reread a bunch of those. I used to read those when I was a kid. Although I feel like I read more Betty and Veronica comics over Archie comics. Those are literally the only comics I've ever read in my life. I do want to read Marvel comics, though, eventually.
I'm going to prove to you beyond the shadow of a doubt that Archie is all about pussy. Come on.
Is he always like that?
Ever since the third grade. Shit like that's bound to happen when you make a kid wear matching tie and slacks every day.
Right. You play darts?
Not professionally. You know, only in bars.
I don't know. Maybe I should just sign one of those exclusive deals like you guys. Your new book seems to be selling like mad.
She throws them so fast, back to back.
A note of bitter envy in there?
Nope. I'm happy my stuff gets read at all.
Did that guy just come out of the women's bathroom?
People like those two outside should be yours. And sadly, there are more of our core audience. You gotta respect that kind of display of affection. You know what I mean? Sure, it's crazy, it's rude, it's self-absorbed.
And that was a woman that just came out of the men's bathroom. I like that in this bar, nobody cares.
That's fleeting.
Fleeting?
Mm-hmm. Well, I got a split. It was really nice meeting you. Good luck with your book. Tell Hooper I'll call him later. And tell your friend to calm down.
I feel like he wants to, you know.
Holden? What? Let's go!
When I hear Holden, I will always and only think of The Expanse Holden.
You like her?
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Miss Alyssa Jones?
Oh, of course he does.
She's all right.
As long as that's all.
Back in Jersey.
It's cool setup they got.
One
of the best streetlights you've ever drawn.
What do you want to do tonight?
I don't know, get a pizza, watch the Grassy Junior High.
You got a weird thing for Canadian melodrama.
What a weird thing for girls who say a boot.
I've never in my life said a boot. It's about.
There's a club shindig going down tonight that I think you'd really get into.
We're prepping the next issue. We get that stupid meeting in the morning.
Told her you wouldn't be interested.
Told who?
Alyssa.
Alyssa. Mm-hmm.
Alyssa from last night, Alyssa?
How do you mm-hmm. begin and end a question with the same word like that? You got skill. Yes, that one.
I'll be there.
Thought so. 10 o'clock later.
So when we leaving?
Lee, you can't go. He's hooking me up with Alyssa. I don't want you messing it up. How are you gonna get home when I hook up, huh?
Like that'll happen.
The other night, we two? Well, we shared a moment.
Oh, you had a moment.
No, shared a moment. One thing was made abundantly clear. This girl loves me.
What is this man doing?
Who's your daddy now? Come on. It's your birthday.
I feel like that was genuine laughter from Buddy sitting down.
You do fall in love?
Where is she?
Over there. Look at her in a net shirt.
I'm not back by Tuesday. Call my mother, all right?
There's something you should know.
She got a boyfriend.
No.
Then what's to know, my friend?
Well, there could be a lot of things that would be good to know.
Hey, lady, you fucked up my cabbage patch!
Well, if it isn't Blunt Man himself, or should I call you Chronic? Little town, New Jersey.
Get out of here, I'm from Highlands.
I know, Hooper told me.
What a small fucking world. Here's the big test, quick stop.
My best friend fucked a dead guy.
You know that girl?
Oh, gosh.
Chicks in this place.
Chicks, you're such a man.
I haven't been back to the burbs since my friend's funeral.
The quick stop girl died?
Another girl, Julie Dwyer, she died.
The YMCA pool! Damn, you knew her too?
I love that they keep calling back to this stuff.
Two towns away from each other for years, we had to meet in New York.
Could have not met at all.
True that.
Maybe you've heard of her stuff, Idiosyncratic Routine. And I think if we all beg her, she'll come up here and treat us with some of her vocal stylings. What do you say, Lisa? Yeah!
Gotta do it.
She's such a cunt.
The way she says that word is actually super adorable.
All right, I should dedicate this, right? This is for that someone special out there. Ready?
Oh man, this dude is falling hard. The way he was just looking at her. It was like a mixture of intrigue and also, bitch, please. You just pushed us out of the way. If you're bored, just leave, dude. Oh my gosh. Yeah. Woo! Is she looking at the, she's looking at the, yeah, Oh no. Man is devastated.
Now that, my friend, is a short moment.
Yes. Yes, it is. Oh, okay. Still going.
What? It's rude. Man, when are we ever going to get a chance to see this kind of shit live without paying for it?
I don't normally get all messy in public, but it's been a while since I've seen Kiln here.
I want to dance.
I'll watch from here. I have to sit here and work up the desire to fuck you later.
Well, how can a girl fuck another girl? Were you talking about strap-ons or something?
I don't know how many times I can apologize for it.
So, for you to fuck is to penetrate.
Clearly.
You inside some girl you duped, jackhammering away, not noticing that bored look in her eyes.
Right? I always notice that bored look in their eyes, all right?
For me, it describes any sex when it's not totally about love. I'm sure you don't love every girl you sleep with.
Some of them I downright loathe.
But I'll bet it's different with the ones you do love. You'll go down on them longer.
Here we go.
I don't do that.
Oh.
You're gonna come off 10 times as stupid on this occasion.
What? My mother brought me up to believe that if I can't do something right, I shouldn't do it at all.
Well, at least you blame yourself for your sexual inadequacies.
No, I blame them.
Oh, of course.
They never tell you what to do, right?
Gotta find yourself some better women.
You gotta handle it like CNN and the Weather Channel. Constant updates.
Okay, but to be real, constant updates when together intimately like that is a good thing. It's important to be communicative.
I was like one of those guys at the airport with those big flashlights, waving them this way, directing them that way, telling them when to stop.
Imagine.
Then there'd be no bullshit, no wasted time, and no chance for, you know, permanent injuries.
As long as the men listen to our direction and are trying to help out.
See that? Uh-huh. I got that from Nina Rollins.
Wait, what?
She does this big old pelvic thrust, cracks my tooth, and sends it down my throat.
I got that beat. I fall asleep. She got so mad she digs her heel into my back. That's permanent. Senior year.
Love that they're comparing. Sharing stories. Does Buddy on the right have anything to chime in with?
Whoa, hey, look at the time. We gotta beat that traffic, huh? Thanks for inviting us out. It was educational. Come on.
Since you like chicks, right? You just look at yourself naked in the mirror all the time?
It's not how that works, I don't think. That was an awesome conversation. Loved that.
What I tell you, she just needs the right guy. All every woman really wants is some serious deep dicking. Everyone needs dick.
I'm sure the gay community appreciates your support.
We'd like to start off by...
Hey, Brian and Matt Damon.
Snoochy booches, huh?
Look, fellas, the days of butthead are over.
That poster in the back behind them, that's freaking me out.
Blunt man in chronic cartoon.
What do you say? Are we in business?
And this would have come out right before Saving Private Ryan.
Yeah, hi. Somebody told me they make comic books here, which is so weird.
Aw.
Hyde tells it when he finds out. Ready for this? This girl is gay. Any interest in a story like that? An animated series?
12 episodes.
Whoa, that's cool.
I don't know if that's really the perception I want people to have of our work. I'd like to think of us as artists, you know?
I weirded you out the other night. You want to talk about it?
If you want to.
I like you, Hogan. I haven't liked a man in a long time. It's not because I'm a man hater. It's just been some time since I've been exposed to a man that didn't immediately live into a stereotype.
Girl, I feel that when you meet men like that, it's so refreshing.
I'd like us to be friends. So if there's anything you want to know, it's okay to ask me.
I feel like this is the start of a very beautiful friendship.
If that's the only reason you're attracted to women, because it's the
no,
standard.
It's more than that.
So you've never been curious about men?
No interest.
Because?
Girls feel right.
Well, that's how I feel. Mm-hmm. You know, I've never really been attracted to men.
So you're still a virgin then?
No.
But you've only been with girls.
Brother.
With a member of the opposite sex.
Why? Why only that?
Because that's the standard.
Oh my gosh.
Virginity is lost when the hymen is broken.
I can be done with a bicycle or a horse or fucking anything.
Because see, I fell on a fence post when I was 10 and it broke my hymen.
Okay.
Fence post.
Virginity is lost through penetration.
Physical penetration or emotional?
Emotional penetration.
Mm, well, I fell in love hard with Caitlin Bree when we were in high school.
Caitlin Bree! She comes up again.
Well, where's the penetration in lesbian sex? I
finger? I've had my finger up my ass. I wouldn't say I've had anal sex.
Observe.
You're kidding me. Jesus, doesn't that hurt?
Sure, but in that good way.
Man is learning a lot. This movie has a lot more sex talk than I was expecting.
It's like, how can that be enough, you know? How big can a tongue really get? My God.
Oh, gosh.
Come on.
He's really gonna have to give me a minute, I think.
Man was imagining things he shouldn't have been imagining.
Oh, my God. Who are you, Larry fucking Flint? What are you gonna do with all those?
She got like 30 books in there. We're only gonna be gone for 2 days.
Put that stuff away.
Don't give him one of those books.
What's up? I'm about to get on a train.
Oh, why?
Last minute invite to the Boston Con.
But I was staying all weekend. I wanted to hang out with you.
Both of us don't have to go.
And if you come pick me up, I'll be your best friend.
Where's your apartment?
And then Black Beauty couldn't take it any longer.
I feel like he's going to be so upset that he's not, you know, anyway.
I'm not going. You're going to have to do this one by yourself.
What? Why?
Liz is coming down for the weekend. I want to hang out with her. Call me if you get bored. You roll the ball up the ramp at varying speeds in an effort to pop it into the score circle.
Well, what do you do with the prize tickets?
You trade them in for prizes, which are not worth nearly as much as you paid to play the game.
That's how it works. I could never, ever get them in the 100 holes.
And this is where you take straight chicks on dates.
Oh, this place is like Spanish Fly. So what'd you do last night?
Got laid.
Well, that's not good. Oh, wow. That sweater looks like the sweater from Knives Out that, Ransom was wearing. You know what? I like these two. I'm excited to see where this goes. Oh, this is cute. That's weird cake. She loves it though, so it's fine.
It's like the umpteenth time I've seen you here. Isn't that grounds enough for the little pink mafia?
Okay, so we've had like multiple. It hasn't just been the weekend. It's been like multiple, I think, I feel. What did he just do to that lighter to make it work? That must be a trick I don't know about. Let me know in the comments.
The chick bugs me.
And don't call her a dyke. She's a lesbian.
She's programming you!
For what?
What does it matter if I refer to her as a dyke, far from the sensitive ears of the rest of the world?
It's passive-aggressive gay bashing. And I know you're not really prejudiced at heart. I just think you should find some other way to express your anger, is all I'm saying.
I'm on his side with this. It's important to call out people when they're using old language that doesn't sit right with most people anymore, and you know, language is always changing, words are evolving, society changes, times change. What are we doing?
Which one is going to get to the $100 bill first? The male-friendly lesbian, the man-hating dyke, Santa Claus, or the Easter Bunny?
The man-hating dyke.
Good. Why?
I don't know.
Because the other three are figments of your fucking imagination!
I don't need this.
You know you have no shot at getting her into bed. Why do you bother wasting time with her?
Because it's important to have friends. Oh my God. So is she Amy and he's chasing her? I really hope that he isn't deep inside like trying to change her in some way so that they are together romantically, because that would be really disappointing. But
what the fuck makes this bitch all that important?
Because I'm fucking in love with her, man, okay?
Okay, there it is. Conversation's weighing on him. I'm going to be that person that says right now that there is a massive difference between romantic love for someone and platonic love for someone. There are lots of people out there that have a huge amount of love for their best friends. The optimistic part of me is hoping that these two have that like very strong best friend relationship. But I can't help but feel like we're going to run into a big hurdle.
It is a gift from me to you, so you'll always remember us.
Oh boy. I feel confrontation, maybe?
Why are we stopping?
Because I can't take this.
Can't take what?
I love you.
The thunder. Dramatic effect.
I love you. Not in a friendly way.
Okay.
You are the epitome of everything I have ever looked for in another human being. I had to say it. I can't stand next to you without wanting to hold you.
I'm really curious how she's going to respond to this, because this is a lot of information to process when you're receiving it. I hope he feels better for...
So I've never felt this way before.
Getting it out.
And if bring this to light means we can't hang out anymore, then that hurts me. But God, I couldn't allow another day to go by without just getting it out there. I know that some part of you is hesitating for a moment. And if there's a moment of hesitation, then that means you feel something too. You just not dismiss that. I would risk this friendship for the chance to take it to the next plateau. But I am forever changed because of who you are and what you've meant to me. I'd never need a painting of Bert spotted at a diner to remind me of.
No. Oh, man. I get both sides of this.
This is something I said.
Brother. Oh, man, I feel for him because I have been in his shoes. Not that the person that I was into was gay. Just someone that didn't reciprocate, right? I feel like we've all been there.
That was so unfair. You know how unfair that was. It's unfortunate that you're in love with me. Do you remember for one fucking second who I am?
People change.
Oh, it's that simple. What about me, Holden? I just can't get into a relationship with you without throwing my whole fucking world into upheaval.
There's always going to be a period of adjustment.
You're asking her to adjust her sexuality.
There's no period of adjustment, Holden. I am fucking gay.
Exactly.
And you assume that I can just turn all that around because you've got a fucking crush?
If this is a crush, I don't think I can take it if the real thing ever happened.
Go home, Holden.
But I also understand where she is at. And I understand that, like, awkwardness that comes with, like, you think you've got a really solid friendship with someone of the opposite sex when you're used to just being talked to because they're into you in that way, right? It can suck when you were stoked about a friendship and then they do the whole, like, oh, I'm into you and I want to be with you kind of thing. And then it, you know, so. Whoa! Okay! Okay. Well, now I'm very excited to see how the rest of this movie goes. I genuinely was not expecting that. That was a big surprise. But I love that the movie is touching on these kind of topics. This movie feels very adult compared to the other two. And I understand the characters are all, and the actors are all older, so kind of makes sense, but... Amazing. I love that. Oh my gosh, his facial expression killed me. All right, well, maybe he has made her realize that she's bi. Wouldn't be the first time that that's happened to anyone.
This is all gonna end badly.
You don't know that.
I know you. You're way too conservative for that girl. She's been around and seen things we've only read about in books.
Yeah, I've read about them, so we're prepared.
There's no we here.
He's like, this is all you, buddy.
You'll spend most of your time wondering when the other shoe's gonna drop. Because for you, this isn't about cool, weird sex stuff. It's about love.
I just noticed his hat says Snoochie Booches. Or Snoochie Boochies.
Everybody has an agenda, all right? My agenda is to watch your back, to ensure that all this time we've spent together building something wasn't wasted.
She's not gonna ruin the comic.
I wasn't talking about the comic.
Oh man, pre-9/11 movie. Old New York City skyline.
What I'd like to know is why we're even here at all when we haven't seen Prince's funny book in a month.
I'm so in love.
That chick you left the restaurant with that night.
They're not from around here. They're from my hometown.
Why are you playing the pronoun game?
What? What are you talking about? I'm not even.
You are. We have a great time. They're from my hometown.
Holden.
Well, they mad at her?
Here's to the both of you. Another one bites the dust.
It's okay to like both. You don't have to pick men or women. You can like both. I had a feeling her friends would pick up on her use of they to avoid saying he.
Why not you?
Oh, I'm a guy. Then why this?
You're different. You're special.
I came to this on my own terms. You know, I didn't just heed what I was taught. I'm not with you because of what family, society, life tried to instill in me from day one. How seldom it is that you meet that one person who just gets you. It's so rare. And to cut oneself off from finding that person, that just seems stupid to me. So I didn't. But then you came along. I mean, you were a guy. And while I was falling for you, I put a ceiling on that. Because you were a guy. Until I remembered why I opened the door to women in the first place. To not limit the likelihood of finding that one person.
This is lovely. I love their conversations.
I feel justified lying in your arms. Because I got here on my own terms.
That was sweet, what she just said.
Well, can I at least tell people all you needed was some serious deep dicking, you know?
No, they're cute. This is shaping up. I mean, I think we're like just over halfway through. This is shaping up to be my favorite one so far.
Finger cuffs. She had a weird nickname. What's your point?
Do you know why it's finger cuffs? Remember Coey London? I ran into him at the stores the other day.
So Rick's the one that came up with the nickname, because that day she had us locked in tight from both sides like a pair of goddamn Chinese finger cuffs.
She's full of shit. She's never even been with a guy.
That's what she says.
Coey London is pulling your chain, okay? In fact, you even believe him for a minute. Makes you look like a complete fucking idiot.
People don't forget shit like finger cuffs. And what if it got out that she's queer as well? How do you think that's gonna make you look?
Well, I give a shit of what people think. Yeah, I'm telling you, she's never even been with a guy, much less these two fucking zeros.
And the bitch could be a bigger fucking germ farm than that monkey in Outbreak.
You let go, okay? I'm fucking tired of this shit. She's my goddamn girlfriend. Do you understand that? If I ever even hear you so much as fucking mention that Alyssa looks a little peaked from now on, I'll put your fucking teeth down your throat.
Sex room. Here lies Dick Boy.
He's having a real problem with this Alyssa thing.
I think it's more like Banky's having a real problem with all things not hetero right about now. I'm just another paradigm of said aberration. I think he is a bit homophobic. This latest episode between you and Miss Thang has tapped into that. His warped perception, he lost you to the dark side.
You make it sound like me and him were dating.
Don't kid yourself. That boy loves you in a way that he ain't ready to deal with.
He's been digging up dirt on Alyssa.
Honey. And just what has Mr. Angela Lansbury uncovered about your lady fair? He's not gonna make you see the error of your ways by pointing out how truly gay she's not.
That's kinda gotten to me.
So what if it is true? Would that bother you?
Sex with multiple partners. Ooh. At the same time.
Oh no. Also, how long ago was it? Like.
So you don't think she's been in the middle of an all-girl group girl?
See, that doesn't bother me.
He wants to be the one that, like, changed her. You know, a lot of men out there, I don't know, weirdly get off on that idea that, like, they were the one that, you know, woo. I kind of get that feeling from him now, but I don't want him to be that way.
Maybe what's really troubling you is that your fragile fantasy might not be true.
What does that mean?
Hold on. Don't even try to come off like you don't know what I'm saying.
Is it what I'm thinking?
They're Marco fucking Polo when it comes to sex. Like, they're the only ones who've ever explored new territory. And it's hard not to let them believe it.
Kinda. We're kinda on the same page.
The world would be a better place if people would just accept that there's nothing new under the sun. Anything you can do with a person has probably been done long before you got there.
150% agree with that.
Ask the girl about her past point blank. Get it out of the way before it gets too big for both of y'all to move.
Especially at the age that they are. Like, it's one thing if you guys are, like, 18 years old and you're, you know, once you're past, like, your mid-20s.
Since most of these people are rooting for the home team.
Oh, man, this is weighing on him. You can just tell.
The kind that until recently had no dicks and would stay the night.
That was until recently, right?
Yeah. Something on your mind, Holden? If I've been faithful or something. I only have eyes for you.
The story that he was told, I can't remember the timeline that was on that, like when he said that happened.
What's with finger cuffs?
Yeah, wasn't that a high school yearbook? So that would have been like 9 years ago from the ages they are now, right? Or college yearbook, maybe?
Your senior yearbook, it said your nickname senior was finger yearbook, cuffs. Right. What does that mean?
Damned if I can remember. What did you see in North Yearbook?
Do you know a guy named Rick Darris?
Sure, we used to hang out in high school. We just hung out a lot. Me, Rick, and,
I feel like I hear a heartbeat.
Coey London! God, I haven't thought about that name in years. Really took advantage of my parents never being home.
The way she's describing it is not helping his brain right now.
His dick out and started chasing me around the house with it.
What did you do?
I blew him while Coey fucked me!
Excuse me?
That's what you wanted to hear, isn't it? Well, next time, try not to make it so obvious, all right?
Ease, man. Even I knew what you were getting at.
All you had to do was ask. I would have gladly volunteered it. You didn't have to go playing Hercule fucking Poirot.
I mean, he wouldn't have known about it if it wasn't for his buddy, Banksy, Banky, whatever his name is.
Get the fuck off me!
So what? So it's true, right?
Yeah, Holden, it's true. Everything you heard or dug up on me is probably true.
What the fuck's wrong with you? How could you do all those things?
Easily! Some I did out of stupidity, some I did out of what I thought was love, and I am not making apologies for them now. And how dare you lay a guilt trip on me about it, in public no less.
How the fuck am I supposed to feel about all this?
Feel whatever the fuck you want to feel about it, alright? The only thing that matters is how you feel about me.
They fucking use you.
No! I use them! Oh. I was an experimental girl, for Christ's sake. And like you, I was not given a fucking map at birth. So I tried it all. That is until we got together. Can't you take some fucking comfort in that? You turned out to be all I was looking for. That missing piece in the big fucking puzzle.
Oh, she's so great at acting these like really emotional scenes.
You have zero problem with me sleeping with half the women in New York City. You have some sort of half-assed, mealy-mouthed objection to pubescent antics that took place almost 10 years ago.
That's what I thought, a decade ago.
I want us to be something that we can't be.
And what's that?
A normal couple.
What even is normal? If everyone acted this way with finding out people's pasts, like, nobody would be together. You could only have one relationship, the very first one, and if that doesn't work out, then you can't have another one, ever. I can't remember the actress's name that's playing her, but her and Ben, their back and forths, their acting, very good. So now I'm curious if this is going to be like a makeup happy ending movie or a... Yes, my boys! Finally!
Smile a long face, Horace. Back you on the rag.
I'm just having a little girl trouble.
Bitch pressing charges. I get that a lot.
Can't do it, G. I'm in love.
Life ain't nothing but bitches and money.
Thanks, guys. That's just what I needed.
Who is this girl?
I don't think you know her.
Oh, they do, I'm sure.
I'm playing, man. Come on, tell me your name, Mysterio.
Alyssa Jones.
Holy fucking shit. Finger cuffs? You're dating finger cuffs, you silly son of a bitch?
I love her, you know, but he has a past.
I'll say, stuffing two guys, eating chicks out and shit.
I ate your fucking bagel already and shut up.
Look at this touchy motherfucker right here.
All that experience, you know? I mean, what am I supposed to think?
I think you're insecure a little.
Bitch tasted life, yo. Now she's selling for your boring, funny bookmaking ass.
Oh, Jay.
It's like I can't get these visuals out of my head of her doing all this
shit. That is a you fucking problem, dude.
I think so much of this girl, and I can't get stupid shit like finger cuffs out of my head.
Chasing Amy.
Silent movie. By Silent Bob, no less.
You're chasing Amy.
What do you look so shocked for, man? Fat bastard does this all the time. He thinks just because he don't say anything, it'll have some huge impact when he does open his face.
Jesus Christ, why don't you shut up? I was yap, yap, yapping all the time. Give me a fucking headache. A couple years ago, this chick named Amy.
Oh.
Then why don't I remember this?
Bitch, what you don't know about me, I'm just about squeezing the Grand fucking Canyon. Did you know I always wanted to be a dancer in Vegas? But you didn't even know that shit, did you?
Best Silent Bob scene so far. Figures the scene where he's talking a lot.
And then 4 months down the road, the idiot gear kicks in. And I ask about the ex-boyfriend.
The idiot gear kicks in. I love that.
It seems that a couple of times, he brought some people to bed with him. This just blows my mind, right? I mean, I am not used to this sort of thing. And I just start blasting her. Like, I don't know how to deal with what I'm feeling, so I figure the best way is by call her slut, right? And tell her she was used. I'm out for blood. And she's just all calmly trying to tell me, like, it was that time and it was that place. And she doesn't think she should apologize because she doesn't feel that she's done anything wrong. That's when I look her straight in the eye. I tell her it's over. I walk. It was a mistake. I wasn't disgusted with her. I was afraid. And I felt small. Like I'd lacked experience. I'd never be enough for her or something like that. But what I did not get, she wasn't looking for that guy anymore. She was looking for me, for the Bob. But by the time I figured this all out, it's too late, man. She moved on. And all I had to show for it was some foolish pride, which then gave way to regret. She was a girl. I know that now.
My heart.
I pushed her away.
Bob's advice is so much better than Jay's.
So I've spent every day since then chasing Amy.
Well, heck.
Enough of this fucking melodrama. My advice? Forget her, dude. There's one bitch in the world, one bitch with many faces.
Oh, man. The eye roll. I love this. That was great. That was so good.
What's that shit you gotta say?
Snoochie boochies.
Snoochie boochies. Who the fuck talks like that? That is fucking baby talk.
Snoochie boochies.
Keep your union on you.
I'll try. No. Do or do not. There is no try. No
knock
try.
That shit off. You got a bus to catch.
Oh my gosh, I miss playgrounds like this. Oh my gosh. Bro, stop looking in the yearbook. Just fucking light it on fire at this point. What I would give to fucking play on a playground like this. There's got to be some in the world that still exist, right?
Now, I know you guys are probably wondering why I asked you both here at the same time tonight.
Well, I just figured you wanted to kill two birds with one stone.
Mackie, there's tension between you and I for the first time in our lives. You hate me dating Alyssa, and you want me to sign off on this whole cartoon thing. Alyssa, you and I have hit a wall. I don't know how to deal with your past, I guess.
It's a nice way of putting it. I'd have said the whole double stuff thing.
I feel inadequate. So you've had such a big life and so much experience, and my life's been pretty small in comparison.
That doesn't matter to me.
Please.
Yeah, let him talk. He's got to get it all out, and then you can speak.
Something that's been obvious forever, and I guess I just didn't acknowledge it. You're in love with me.
What?
I mean, it makes sense. We've been together so long. We have so much in common.
Well, I gotta get going.
That would explain your jealousy of Alyssa, your homophobia.
Jesus, just because a guy's got a predilection toward dick jokes.
Thank you. Deal with it. You'll feel much better.
Man just had the largest realization hit him.
I know what we have to do. You, Alyssa, and I, all of us, can finally be all right.
Please don't say it.
We've all got to have sex together. That would take care of everything.
I'm Alyssa right now.
And it won't be a total leap for you because a woman will be involved.
I love how he's rationalizing this. Like, I can't be mad at him.
This will keep us together.
This is dangerous.
What do you say?
What do you say as if he's just proposed, like, a casual hangout at the mall?
Sure.
Is this actually gonna happen?
No. Oh,
thank Christ. Sorry.
But sweetheart, you've done stuff like this before. I mean, it should be no big deal for you.
You don't want this.
This has to happen. When it's over, we'll be the strongest we've ever been. Because we'll have been through this together. And then we'll be on the same level together.
That time is over for me. I've been there and I've done it. And I didn't find what I was looking for in any of it. I found that in you. Doing this won't help you forget about the things you're hung up on. It'll create more. Maybe I'll moan differently. And then you'll resent Banky and become suspicious of us.
That's a great point, actually. I didn't even think of that. You can tell that he didn't really think about all of the potentials.
I've been down roads like this before. I know you feel doing this will broaden your horizons, but I've had those experiences on my own, and I can't accompany you on yours. Or maybe I just love you too much, and I feel hurt and let down that you would want to share me with anyone, because I would never want to share you.
No.
I can't be a part of this. Or you. Not anymore. I love you. I always will.
Whew. This movie hits, yo. Oh, Jesus Christ, okay.
But I'm not your fucking whore. He's yours again.
She's like, bye, have fun. Although, Banky was the one that told him about all of that, that all led to this. I mean, I feel like it's possible that Holden would have found out anyway at some point, but he would have found it out from her and not through Banky doing it to just drum up everything. It's unfortunate. Wow, time jump. 1 year later. All right. Aw.
You sign it and push that up even higher.
You sell it, I want a kickback.
I heard once that there was going to be an animated series.
They're looking at it. No chronic, no cartoon.
So is that what happened with you and Holden McNeil? You got into a fight over the rights or something?
It was a little more complicated than that.
Oh, shit.
Whatever happened to that guy?
With the biz, I guess.
You guys don't talk anymore?
No, not really.
No meeting once.
Aww.
Kind of like Nomad, you know?
So they're each doing their own thing now?
Bag on page 18. Look at how you draw a fart and...
Moment.
McNeil. I mean, you were, you know what I'm saying?
Wow. Figured he was coming over. Chasing Amy.
This isn't one of mine.
It's mine. I saved you a copy.
Hi. How have you been?
Good. Really good. Yourself?
Good. I haven't even seen this yet. Did it just come out?
Oh, about a month ago. I did a really small run.
Will I enjoy it?
You might. It's familiar subject matter.
You have to put the individual ahead of their actions always. Oh, I'm sorry, Alyssa, wherever you are.
Looks like a very personal story.
Finally had something personal to say.
That's what I love about stories, is so much of it is people just communicating what they need to say, what they feel.
Read that if you have a minute.
I will.
You can tell they both still have feelings.
It was really nice seeing you again.
It was really nice to see you too.
Who was that?
Just some guy I knew.
And if they don't ever end up together, now he's another guy in her past that some future guy can be jealous over because of how much she was in love with him. If you enjoyed my reaction to Chasing Amy, the best way to let me know is by clicking that like button down below, and I'm going to be continuing the View Askewniverse. My plan is one per month until we're done, so if you're not yet subscribed, definitely make sure you are so you can come back for that, provided that nothing completely derails my schedule, like with what I've experienced a little bit recently. Then we should be good to go. I'm very excited to watch Dogma, which is up next. Guys, Chasing Amy is my new number one. I liked it more than Clerks. I liked it more than Mallrats. This was a solid 5 out of 5 movie for me personally. And before I get into the reasons why, I do just want to acknowledge that I can understand that this movie in particular would not be everyone's cup of tea, even if you do enjoy the other movies in the View Askewniverse. Obviously, I still don't know what's to come, but just talking about the three so far, I was not expecting this movie to be so heavy on the sex and the sexuality and the romance and the platonic friendships and like these types of topics. We've had a little bit of it in both Mallrats and Clerks, but this movie was like from start to end, it was all about that. And it was a pleasant surprise for me because these topics are not taboo for me. I've never shied away from talking about this stuff with partners or with friends. Heck, even here on the internet, back in the day when I streamed on Twitch regularly, I was not one to really shy away from this kind of stuff. If the conversation naturally flowed towards it, I was someone who encouraged it rather than shut it down. And so I had had some really good conversations with myself and viewers over the years. Anytime this did come up, people knew that they could come to my stream if they needed to talk about relationship issues or anything like that. And it was fun to just relate to one another and talk about these shared experiences and give advice to one another and stuff. And so this movie really hit that part of me and reminded me of that, and this movie just felt very relatable. And in so many ways, I felt like I could relate to Alyssa, and in so many ways, I felt like I related to Holden a lot. And weirdly, in so many ways, I also felt that I could relate to Banky. And so thinking back on this movie, there were so many scenes with such rock solid conversations. The one that obviously stands out the most to me is Silent Bob. Silent Bob unsilencing himself and coming out and actually talking for a few minutes in a row, explaining a situation, and also giving us context and explanation for why the movie was called Chasing Amy in the first place. That was such a top scene for me, but there were so many other scenes that I loved almost as much as that one. This was just such a fantastic movie. I really, really enjoyed this one. Joey Lauren Adams and Ben Affleck, my gosh, these two and their back and forths, it was so good. Joey Lauren Adams in particular, her acting during those emotional moments where she was like screaming and crying. She's such a tiny person, like she's so short. And so her just like trying to make herself taller with tears streaming down her face and yelling with the voice that she has, which is such a soft and quiet and lovely voice. And when she screams, it still stays that way, but just a little bit louder and a little bit more aggressive. Anyway, she's just a fantastic, wonderful actress. Really, really enjoyed her performance in this, especially when comparing to her character in Mallrats. I really love that she was a main character in this. It was a pleasant surprise. Just really enjoyed Alyssa. Ben Affleck. I'll admit that I'm not a fan of him as a person, and I haven't seen a ton of his movies, but I think I already know that Chasing Amy is gonna be my favorite Ben Affleck performance, even down the road as I watch more of his movies. Comparing his character in this one to his character in Mallrats, definitely, definitely preferred Holden way more than the other guy. He plays that like asshole-y character kind of well, but in this one, he was such a normal guy that, you know, got insecurities, felt inadequate, which is very relatable. I'm sure we've all been there. I just really enjoyed his performance here. Thought he did such a great job with all of the scenes. It was just really great to watch. I really appreciate that this movie was not your typical rom-com. Like when you hear that term, you know exactly what type of movie I'm thinking of. This was definitely Kevin Smith's version of a rom-com where the comedy is present and funny, but there's also like very, very real conversations happening here. It just feels so much more relatable than a rom-com ever does, if that makes sense. At least that's how I feel. If you understand, cool. If you don't, that's also fine. Out of all the movies so far, this one definitely had my favorite writing. Just the relatability here for me just makes this movie so wonderful. But I'm also just such a sucker for these types of conversations between people, whether it's fictional or real, doesn't matter. I eat this stuff up like crazy. So, yeah. This is one movie where I actually do want to go to the wiki real quick and just see if there's anything that Kevin Smith has said about the making of this movie or anything. I just want a little bit more insight into his mind with this one, so give me one sec. Though the film has been praised as ahead of its time by some critics in its representation of sexual fluidity and the concept of the bromance, it also received criticism, particularly for its implication that a lesbian can go straight, even if just temporarily, as soon as she meets the right guy. I can understand that criticism. The thing is, even since 1997, sexuality has become even more fluid, probably far beyond what people could think back then. And a lot of people have realized that they're bisexual after being gay or straight for however long. Smith later said, for anyone who watches the movie now and goes like, ew, these sexual politics are not very subtle, you've got to remember, it was made by a 26-year-old, 27-year-old guy who really didn't know anything and was learning in that moment. As much as it's a movie that's closely identified with the gay community by virtue of the fact that the main character was gay, I never really think about it as such. To me, it was about a boy who grows up to become a man but loses everything in the process. Very bittersweet. I love that. And honestly, in many ways, like, you can tell that the movie was made by a 26, 27-year-old guy, because when I think about myself at those ages, which is a while ago now, longer ago than it feels, to be honest, I think about who I was back then, and yeah, those types of conversations that we saw in the movie very much resemble conversations I had with friends and partners back then. And so in a weird way, this movie almost gives me kind of a nostalgic feeling for being younger. Quentin Tarantino considered Chasing Amy his favorite movie of 1997. That's cool. All right, while I have things up over here, I am gonna go to Letterboxd now to see what some other people have to say about Chasing Amy, so let's go. 4.5 star review by Brian, who says, half of this movie's problems would be solved by the word bisexual, and I will not lie, that was on my mind the whole time, and I feel like I said it more than once in my reaction. Editor me will go back and maybe do a count, I don't know. I normally don't include such low reviews of movies in these segments of my videos, but I do wanna include this one just to kind of open up the conversation about it. I know it was a different time and everything, but all of the interpersonal conflict in this movie feels like it takes place on another planet. Nothing anyone feels or experiences in this movie is something that has happened on planet Earth to an actual person. Affleck is surprisingly good, though, I gotta say. And I find that interesting because I personally consider them exaggerating when they say that. Like, there's no possible way that you can know the lived experiences of every single person that has ever lived on this planet, right? It's impossible. And the fact that we now know today and will continue to evolve with sexuality being as fluid as it is, that means that, in my personal opinion, the feelings expressed in this movie and some of the things that have happened have definitely happened to real people out there in real life. I can understand the LGBTQ community's criticisms of this movie with the portrayal of Alyssa and how that kind of happened, but to say that it's never happened to anyone ever is something that you just would never know. Right? I'm gonna include this one too. No star rating at all. Just simply says, this film is so unrealistic and offensive. I'm so tired of men and their dumbass savior complexes. Like, yes, this movie is over 20 years old, but there are still some boys acting like Ben Affleck's character. And they're out here thinking that women need to be deep-dicked and serenaded by punk rock songs to understand the true meaning of life. Honestly, that review is relatable. This is a longer review, but it's gonna be the final one. I'm gonna include it because I really love it. 3 stars by Chad, who says, very curious to scroll through here and read some opinions from LGBT members on this one. I remember liking it in high school, but threw it on tonight, fully expecting it to be regressive cringe. And sure enough, Ben Affleck's character is 100% wrong on everything. His attitude, his actions, it's all supremely wrong-headed, misogynist, selfish, and ignorant. But Joey Lauren Adams' character is actually 100% right on everything and crushingly and comprehensively calls him out on his bullshit every step of the way. So that means Kevin Smith was actually pretty progressive and still decided to make his movie about a dumb idiot man baby that never learns the correct lesson, which kind of makes this interesting. I don't know. It did make me miss those 90 days when movies had scripts with a capital S. 90s days. Also, the notion that Ben Affleck and Jason Lee are adult men in 1996 who hang out in New York City and have never seen a gay kiss up close and personal is an insane thing that is both totally plausible and probably impossible for my son to wrap his brain around when he's older. That I lived almost a full 20 years on this earth without ever speaking to an openly gay person or see them kiss. It's embarrassing how much movies like this and In-N-Out actually were educational to me in 1997. Honestly, I'll agree with that reviewer because I have been scrolling through these reviews and have seen a lot of very low-rated reviews by people. It's really interesting to read those. I am not a member of that community. I am straight as an arrow, so I cannot speak for that community at all. If you are somebody that is part of that community that watched my videos, I would definitely be interested in hearing your thoughts in the comments about this movie and how you see it. And that is where I'm going to wrap up this video. Thank you so much for watching this with me. I look forward to your comments down below. Let me know what you love about this movie. Let me know if you don't care for this one. Just looking forward to having a conversation about it. And next month I'll be putting out a reaction to Dogma, so definitely come back for that. I think Dogma seems to be a lot of people's favorites out of the franchise, so very excited to see that one for myself. As always, thank you to folks on Patreon for the financial support. And if you're not yet subscribed, click here. And if you want to watch something else of mine, click on over here. And with that, we'll see you in the next one. Take care.